my streaming again. Okay, but I think I got it live now. Okay, so sorry guys, we'll catch up afterwards. Yeah. Today we are very lucky to have Elijah with us. Right, she's actually a chartered accountant, right, that actually looks at helping startup and SME with building up their business or actually starting up a business. So she will share with us some of her little secrets on how to actually, you know, start your company. A lot of time as an investor, I find that there are issues with actually the corporate structure, right? So sometimes they come with us with a structure which we have to undo before investment can go in, right? So I hope today, you know, she'll give you a little bit of light on that side of things. So without further ado, let me just invite Elijah. Okay, that's a good one. Okay, I am as new as you are to this.
And I started my company as well during that period. I actually worked as a freelance from 2009, and thereafter I actually expanded my firm in 2014. Okay, why did I expand the company? Is because I want to help others. Okay, I myself actually I work as a freelance when I'm actually taking care of my kid at home. Practically, I'm taking care of my 1-year-old boy and actually doing my accounts at the same time. Okay, and that is why I think that there's something is wrong. There is no work-life balance, and even professional who are mommies and daddies who wanted to work from home, they can't do it at that time. So which is the reason why I founded the company and then expanded. So now we have 6 staff. 2 of my staff, they're actually working on flexible work mode. They're allowed to work from home, and they're also just required to come to the office just twice a week at all as well. Because we are using cloud technology to do accounting, we are using Google Chat, we are using our WhatsApp WeChat as well to communicate with our customer. Okay? So for my firm, what we do is that, okay, we have staff doing accounting, and for me, I should more on the consultation. So to cut it short, okay, basically what I'm sharing today is all about entrepreneur, what you need to know when you start a business, okay, and what you need to know after you start a business. Okay, first thing, okay, in Singapore we have a few types of business structure that you wish to know. The cheapest and the easiest method will start from a sole proprietorship, which means you are the only owner, okay, no other people. Okay, and you have a partnership where you actually share with another person. Okay, and this partnership you can have one partner, two partners, all the way up to 20 partners. Okay, and we also have this called limited liability partnership. Okay, the difference between these two is that this partnership is formed when the liability of each individual partner is generally limited. So when you go for a partnership, it's unlimited. So that's the issue comes when you are being sued by somebody. So what happens is that when your creditor sue you for certain issue, okay, you might be bankrupt because of certain issue. And we also have a limited partnership, which is an involved from limited liability partnership, where you can have two partners. One can be a general partner, and the other is a limited partner. Okay. Last but not least is the one that is called company. We call it a private limited company. And for this company, this is good where we can have a separate distinction between the directors and the shareholder, which means I can be a shareholder, but that doesn't mean I need to be a director. So I can just put in my money in this company, let's say StarHub. I can be a shareholder, I buy their share, but it doesn't mean I can be a director because I got no support. Nobody wants me to be a director. So likewise, like a private limited company, okay, you can have somebody who actually invests in your company as a shareholders, and they can actually appoint a managing director or just an executive director to manage the company. Okay. Now, let's look at what is the difference when you have these two types of companies. I will just briefly divide the companies into sole proprietorship, partnership, LLP, and LP. I will just group that into one. Why I put these four types into one? Because their financial year end and their tax calculation, they are different from a private limited company. Okay? So when you start a company, you need to understand all this, because this will affect your personal tax, and this will affect the way how you treat your salary, your dividend, how you get all your grants, your claims as well. So, important dates that we are looking here is the financial year end will always be the last day of the year. Okay, anybody has a sole proprietorship here? So, I believe you know this,
no,
right?
No, not sole proprietorship,
LLP. LLP, okay. So, basically, when do you do your tax?
Well, actually, generally, my partner does that, so shortly before the end of the year.
Correct. So, basically, when you do your tax, what happens is that you will actually do your accounts first at the end of the year. So between January to April, you will go through what are the things that can be claimable and non-claimable, and you will divide by the number of partners. Am I right to say that?
Yeah.
Okay. And are you taxed personally or by the corporate tax?
This is we don't have corporate tax, right?
Yes, correct. He is right. So you will be taxed under personal tax. Okay, so that is the difference. Okay, and in Singapore, you have to understand the tax rate. Okay, is different from resident and non-resident. Okay, so which means if you are Singaporean, naturally you will be a Singapore tax resident. But if you are foreigner, it doesn't mean you are not going to be. You can still be a resident taxation rate. Okay, so what we do is that a foreigner who actually stay and work in Singapore for more than 183 days, and you will be considered as a tax resident. This is very important, because without this, you will be paying more tax. And tax rate is very, very huge difference if you look at the tax later, which I'm going to show. So 0%, that's very good. But if you have 120,000 as your chargeable income, okay, your first 80,000, you will need to pay $3,350. And the next 40,000, they will look at the tax rate of 11.5%. Okay? So when you plan your company, you need to understand this. And other than this, you need to pay MediSave, don't forget. Okay? So look at all these things. Basically, for a year, you need to pay about close to 8,000 if you are earning about 120,000 chargeable income. Okay? So it can be a huge sum of money if you have not budget this in your cash flow. Because by the April of next year, when you file in, maybe May or June, should be in June, you will get a love letter from IRAS asking you to make the payment. So all this you might have to budget in, because like 8,000 could be more than enough to pay for your rental for 6 months. Okay, and then for the high earning capability people, the first 320,000 you will be paying 44,000 of tax. Okay. Next. Okay. So these are all for the previous one will be for residents. So what about if you are non-resident? Any foreigner here? Any foreigner? No, all Singaporean. Okay, marvelous. First time I find no foreigner here. Then I shouldn't be doing this, okay? Anyway, you can just share with any of your friends who are foreigner, and if they are not staying in Singapore for more than 183 days, they will pay a higher tax rate. So in terms of employment income, it will be 15% of the progressive, which means if you're earning more than the certain rate, based on the tax rate, resident tax rate, you'll be taxed on the higher. So they look at the higher amount. So IRS is very smart. They won't let you go off so easily. And what about other fee? Okay, director's fee will be taxed at 22%. And all other income, you will look at like gross income will be 15% or 22% of net income. When you look at net income, that means they will have to deduct all other expenses. Okay, and it will be allowable expenses. So if you're going to buy a Chanel bag, it's not claimable. Okay, that is definitely not claimable. Don't laugh, because I have an online fashion wear client, basically she bought bags. So that is claimable, because you know why? The models need to, you know, use the bags and then to, it's accessory, shoes, all these things. But it must not be expensive, because for this e-commerce fashion wear, their targets are not super rich tai tai who spend $1,000 on clothes. Okay, their market share is from Toast OL, who spend about less than $50 on a bag. So she doesn't actually need to buy a Chanel bag as an accessory. So we actually look at individual. But if let's say you are an IT company, will you buy a Chanel bag?
Yes.
Really? Thank goodness. Okay.
But it's
yeah, but it could be, it will not be for business expenses, definitely. So these are the things we have to take note. As an accountant, we will let our customer know, and I think it might not be claimable, okay? Because if you want, I can put it in, but the problem is IRAS will come to you. This is definitely not a business expense, okay? IRAS is very simple. Whatever you can claim will just be business expenses, and it must be at market value. So if you are looking at a petrol claim of 400, 500, even 800 is still possible, but if you're claiming of petrol of like $3,000 a month, that is just excessive. So they are aware of all these things. Yeah. Okay. So now comes to the private limited company. I would like to touch on this very a lot more, because for startup company, okay, a lot of companies doesn't know that they actually need to focus on the business structure before they start anything. Okay. They will just think that, okay, I'll just go to Accra and then I'll just set up a company. But in the end, when it comes to the second phase, when they need funding, problem comes. If you are sole proprietorship, how can new investor come in? Is it through share swap? Or is it through merger acquisition of the whole company? That is the problem. So what happened is they may have to incorporate another company or to move the operation from sole proprietorship partnership to a private limited company. Okay? So before you set up any company, think carefully the path. Do you need funding? If not, you can go on to be a so-called leadership or partnership, it's okay. If you really need funding, look at the possible things that you will encounter. Like, investor would like to know what is your unaudited financial statement, your tax, okay, how they can come in. Are they going to get 20%, 30% of the share? So will it be incremental? And the cost of the share value, that means the market value. So they will need to know all these things. Okay. Which is why Singapore government is very good. They actually introduced a startup scheme where for the first 3 years, you will just, practically first 3 years, I don't think you need to pay any tax. Because for the first 100,000, you will get 100% tax exemption. Zero tax at all. Okay? And for the next 200,000, you will get 50%, which is another 100,000. In total, you have a saving of 200,000. Okay? In simple, if you compare this with a sole proprietorship, a partnership, and an LLP, basically, for the first 3 years, you pay zero tax when you have 100,000 of chargeable income. Okay? Which is the net after you deduct all the allowable expenses. Okay? Which is very good. And what happened after that? Government still give you exemption, which is 10,000 for 75%, and the next 290,000 at 50%. And over here, your saving will be $152,500. And not just this, I don't know why government is so good. Okay, another 50% corporate tax rebate at 20%, at 20,000. So which means, if you are paying a tax of 200,000, after that, okay, when we calculate the whole thing, let's do a simple calculation. When we calculate the whole thing, and you need to pay a tax of 50,000, okay, you will get a tax rebate of 50%. But 50% times 50,000 is actually 25,000. You won't get that. You only get up to 20,000. So 50,000 minus your 20,000, you just have to pay 30,000. So in simple. So government is very helpful to us. Startup company is very helpful to SME company because they want us to grow. We are the fundamental of the Singapore economy. Because as you know, more than 80-90% of our companies are all SME. If they don't help us, once we go down, the whole economy will go down. When you set up a company, okay, a private limited company, okay, basically you will start your incorporation, okay, within 6 months, okay, you will need to appoint your corporate secretary and your auditor. Auditor will only be required if you have more than 10 million in revenue and you have more than 50 staff. So in most startup company, I will just skip this portion. You do not need to appoint an auditor at this stage. You can save your money, okay? But you need a corporate secretary at this point. A corporate secretary can be a friend of yours. They must be local, any friend, but they can also be somebody from a corporate secretary firm because they will inform you, they will help you to sign certain documents. So imagine, you only have one director and one secretary, okay? Because if you are just a sole director, you cannot be a secretary. So you need one director and one secretary. Okay? So in this case, your secretary can help you to sign on documents such as opening a bank account and certain contracts. Okay? And it's chargeable and non-chargeable, so depend on different corporate secretary firm. Okay? And next, at the 12th month, around that period, you will need to do your first financial statement. Okay? So what do we mean by first financial statement? That means you will need to have all your documents on your invoices, your expenses, and you can get an accountant to tabulate everything, and we will have an unaudited financial statement. That is when you are an exempted company and you don't need any audit. Okay? Because the charge of doing an audit will be twice or even three times more than an unaudited fee. Okay? That is why I'm not an auditor. Because for the auditor, they will need to pay twice the amount of the license fee than me. Okay, I'm actually a chartered accountant, but I don't practice I don't do audit, because if I do audit, I need to pay more and I can't do accounts. But I do have an audit partner, so I know how this is how they work. The reason why they have a lot of basic costs like insurance, all these things, that's why audit is usually more expensive. So we don't go on to that. So for startup company, you can forget about auditor. So when corporate secretary mentioned to you that, oh, you need to appoint an auditor, so it's not necessary. So you can skip. You can skip that. Save cost. You don't have to think about that. Okay. So after the 12 months, around there, you will do your financial statement. So at 15 months, you will need to file your ECI. ECI means estimated chargeable income. To who? Yes, correct. They need to know whether you need to pay tax. Okay, so if your chargeable income is zero, you can just ignore. First year, you can just ignore. Normally for first year, we will just ignore because I don't think you will make any profit. So you can just ignore. But whenever you need to pay tax, you estimate that there will be a profit, you need to do a ECI to the government body. And it's all online. Nowadays, everything is online. Okay, and within 18 months, okay, after the financial statement is prepared, we will need to file our AR and AGM. AR means annual return. AGM is annual general meeting. Okay? Even if you are a sole director, you still need to do all these things. And your corporate secretary will actually help you to prepare all the documents, okay? And help you to file with ACRA. Okay? Another small tip that a lot of people don't know when they do incorporation is that if you are an insolvent company, okay, Singapore rules requires you to do SBIL. It's a type of financial statement reporting standard. Okay, I hate that. It's terrible. I hope that they will improve the system. It's an online, it's something like Excel, but you need to fill in a lot of blanks, all these things. It's only applicable if you are an insolvent company. Okay? So we try not to go on to that. So what happens is that what some companies do is they have a share capital and they don't have losses so that they won't be an insolvent company. Okay, so we can save on that cost. Because all these are additional costs that you will incur when you are an insolvent company. Okay?
How do you define an insolvent company?
Okay, in terms of, example, your share capital is $100 and your retained loss is $200. So you can't cover, so we call it an insolvent company. Okay, so what happens is that because of this, you have to do an SBIL. Because when we do the AR filing, they will require us to submit an SBIL report. Okay, that is additional. It's in addition of an unaudited report, financial statement. So some customers, they do not know. Because they do not know that these are all the costs that you will incur. Okay? But there is a way to prevent this, which means your share capital, maybe you will have like $10,000. And when you have a retained loss of $200, you won't be an insolvent company. So you won't need to spend additional money on that. And that is not expensive, it's actually $300. But why you need to spend that $300? Because imagine, for a startup company, what are the costs involved? Definitely you need more than $10,000. So why don't just put a share capital of $10,000? So all these things, a good advisor should actually advise you before you start a company. What are the things that you need to look? Otherwise, at the end of the 12 months, you will be thinking, hi, why I need to do SBIR? Why I need to do this? Why I need to do that? Then you will be very confused. I thought I just said that a company is that simple. So there's a lot of things you need to understand before you start a company. And thereafter, once you do your AR AGM, then comes to the next year. We will do our IRAS filing, which is the Form C and Form CS, by November, 30th November or 15th December of the following years. Which means if my year end is on the 31st, let's say my year is on 31st December 2016, I need to file in November 2017. Okay, that is Singapore context. Okay, it's different from other countries. Different countries have different rules and application. Okay, it also means that they will give us time because our financial year end is on 31st December 2016. You will have about half a year to finalize your account, to do your AR filing. So after that, you have some time to do your tax filing. Okay? So that is for Form C. And then the whole cycle will start to repeat at the 12 month. Another 12 month, you will repeat and repeat again. Okay? So that's... Okay. So can I ask? So you guys know about the difference between sole proprietorship and partnership and private limited. Let me see. can now ask a very simple question. If you have a private limited company, okay, how much saving will you get if you are a startup company or tax? Anybody can?
100,000 for the first 3 years based on your profit.
Okay, 100,000, okay, partially right. 100,000 times 100%. The next 200,000, you will get 50% rebate. Okay, so in total, it's like net, you have 200,000. Okay, so that is a very substantial amount. Okay, but if you are doing like small firm, small trading company, not a tech startup, it's okay to go to a sole proprietorship or partnership because you are just small. You won't need any investor to come in. But for a private limited company, you have all these benefits, so why not use it? And then you can plan all your things properly, which I can share later.
So, how does the government define a startup? If I start a coffee shop, can I qualify as a startup?
Okay. How the company define a startup? Government doesn't define a startup. Company define as 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. The first 3 years, you will get startup rebates. After the third financial year, you will be partial exemption. And every year, we have to remember to listen to Lee Hsien Loong and see what kind of rebates he will give us. Yes, we really need to understand because every year tax will change. Okay? I don't do tax, I have a tax consultant. Because I hate to listen to what will be changed, all these things, like the grants, everything, like PIC claim is also part of the tax. You can choose 400% or you can take back 40% right now. So all these things will change, okay? One more thing, if you're a startup company, if you don't want to do PIC, please make sure you have valid for 3 stars. A lot of people come to me, I have my mother as my, I don't know what, earning $500, My dad is a cleaner earning $200 and my wife doing my accounts earning $1,000, can I claim? I told him, you ask yourself, what will IRS ask when they come to you? Okay, don't do that please, okay? You can go to IRS, check it out. A lot of people has been prosecuted, fined, all these things. And if you are a company, if you are a person who has directorship for a few other companies, rest assured they will come knocking at each and one of your companies. You can do to one company, I'm sure they will do to other companies. So all these things, you need to know the compliance, how you want to get the grant, how you need to get the benefit. Make sure you know the rules and regulation. Okay? So anyone of you doesn't have a company now? Oh. Uncle, right?
Yeah.
Yesterday, right?
Yeah.
The pizza? Okay, yesterday we met at a networking session. Okay, so basically, everyone of you should know basically what you need to know when you start a company. What are the expenses? I know a lot of tech company or a lot of business owner, they are so enthusiastic about their product. Oh, my product is the best. My service is the best. They forget a lot of things about budgeting and what they need to know before they start a company. So I'm going to just highlight a few here, which is the most important thing that you need to know before you start any company. Okay? Because before you tender resignation to your boss, make sure you have the money and the capability to get sales first. Okay? Number one, capital. Okay? Ensure you have 6 months or more before you launch any business. Minimum 6 months. Which means if now I'm earning $5,000 a month. Okay, make sure you have 5,000 times 6, 30K. Okay? Best that you have 12 months, but some people look at 6 months because they think, I can do it in 6 months time. I should be able to get some, you know, profit or some sales to break even or whatever. So look at the industry that you are going into. Whether is it so easy to get the money back? Because you will have to look at tech company. I know some company, they give free service for 1-2 years. So I don't think money will come in. Okay? If you are looking at wet market, you get cash. Immediately you will get money. So that's a different thing. And if you are looking at a printing company, you give a credit terms of 1 month, but they won't pay you immediately. 1 month later you will get money, 2 months. So you have to look at all these things. So 6 months will be the minimum. 12 months will be good. Okay? You have this cash, untouchable cash, waiting for you to use it. So survive for the 12 months, otherwise you will be very miserable. Okay? control it. Okay, I practically now, my income is just $300 per month, even till now. Okay, I get a director fee or a dividend at the end of the month. Okay, because I want to make sure that I have enough money for the business or marketing expenses for my employees. Okay, you have to feed your employees first. If they are happy, you have a happy customer. If your employees are not happy, they won't be helping you at all. From an IP lawyer, okay, that I just met about a few months ago because I got into an accident and then she recommended me a lawyer to sue the other person. Okay, so this IP thing, okay, basically when you set up a company, you have your website, your logo, so these are all your trademarks that you need to know. Okay, so if you're going to build your branding, there will be a worth on it. So you need to identify, are you going to apply a trademark on it. So example, Starbucks. So you cannot say that you are Starbucks, you cannot use that. They will actually sue you for this. And other thing like a tune, if you actually write a tune, write a story, it belongs to you. Nobody is supposed to use it. There will be infringement, okay? But it's nothing if, let's say, you never get a protection on it. There are some documentation that can be done by a lawyer to help you on this. And last of all, for invention. Invention, when there's a new invention, you need to register a patent. And it actually means nobody can use it. If you never register a patent, okay, somebody can just use your invention and sell it. A bigger firm can use your technology that you have created, okay, and mass produce it in China or in any country like Brazil and sell it faster than you because they have the money. And there's nothing you can do because you have not get the necessary patent in that respective countries. So all these things you will need to know, okay, whether if you can request for a patent registration in that countries. You have to look at the invention that you have. Your lawyer will have to talk to you, will help you to search whether this is really something special and you can register for it. It doesn't mean that you want to register, you can register for it, because it can be somebody else has already invented this and you might not know it. So the lawyer will come into a position who will help you to assess about this. Okay? I'm not a lawyer, but this is what is very important because she has seen certain cases when a startup company thought that they have created something so new that nobody has manufactured it. But when they come and talk to her and when they did a search, somebody has already done it in certain countries. Okay, so it's important, especially in tech company, that you know about this. Okay, for patent registration, I remember she told me it takes about 1 year to 2 years. It depends on the detail, the complexity of your product, and what kind of information you divulge to your lawyer, because he or she will need to check all these things. It's very important. And the most important thing, which I never mentioned here, is that if you start a fintech company or IT company, you have your founder and your co-founder. So one important thing, who are the tech guys or who are the tech girls who invented these services? Okay. For the IP, who is the owner? Is it a joint ownership or just a one ownership? All these things you need to iron out before you look for an investor. Because if internally you have not sorted out the thing, how are you going to present to the investor? How are you going to protect yourself? So it's good that if you have a product or you have a service that you're going to launch, talk to an IP lawyer, understand it, okay? Before you make any mistake where some of your competitors steal your ideas and present to the same investor, and they already done the IP earlier than you. So this is one of the important stuff in tech company, which most people doesn't realize it. Because they are just focusing on their service. I'm the best one. I don't think people have done it. But you know, the world is so big, we wouldn't know. Which is why a lawyer comes in the position to help you guys on this. Okay? Think about the word. This is very important. Okay, next. Once you understand about IP, you will need an office. Okay? This is one of the most fundamental things. I believe most of you actually use CoSpace. We have the virtual office, hot desk, common table, etc. For the first 6 months, I would prefer you to get a small office first, because money is not easy to be earned. Okay? Go for a small place, you can have a virtual office, you can just have a hot desk for 6 months. And then after, when you have more manpower coming in, okay, you can actually rent a room, okay, or even a common table. So how it goes. Because I believe all the co-space working area, they actually allow you to, you know, rent a bigger room when you expand. So do not spend any money on getting a permanent room. I have a startup company in engineering firm come to me and say, hey, I'm going to rent this place 2,000 square feet, blah 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 blah. So I went to his place for the opening ceremony. Guess what? Half a year later, not enough sales. And he is in a situation when he has to tell the landlord, I'm sorry, I really can't pay. Can you help me? Yeah. So actually, I think he keeps on paying until he found someone to substitute, to take over his unit. So do not think that a bit of it is very glam. Money is glam. Okay? You need to keep the money for your marketing expenses. Yes, a lot of, especially guys, most of them are guys. They want a big office. I don't know why. They like a big office. They want a cappuccino, espresso. Beer counter would be better, right? That's what he said. Ask me. Hey, can we buy a fridge? I say, yeah, you go and buy. Okay, and I say, photocopier machine. I say, why we need a photocopier machine? I have a cold space office. Outside there's a photocopier machine. I have a 3-in-1. Why I need another photocopier machine? Even though they say PIC, I say, I do not need. Okay? Don't laugh. Guys are like that. It happens many times. I have to advise my client.
Not all guys are like that.
Not all guys.
Bosses are very good.
So be prudent, okay? Be prudent. Okay, next will be your sales strategy. Yes, your service, your product is good. Do you have customer? This is the most important thing. Do you have customer? How are you going to get customer? Like when I first started, I start from home. It's okay. If it doesn't work out, I just take care of my kids. That's all. Slowly, I get more customer. I get my, I actually got another person to help me. So we have 2 person. So you need customer. So for a tech startup, you need to understand, how do you get your customer? Digital marketing, SEO, all this. You guys are much better than me. Okay, I still need help. Anybody can help me, can just look for Silas. It's in charge of marketing, we need to market our company. So you need to have a fix, you need to have a plan, and you need to know how much money you need to put in. Why? For the startup company, you will have a limited fund. Maybe you will spend 100,000 on marketing. So what happens if you finish out your 100,000? You need to look for your investor. So you need to plan properly. How are you going to allocate this 100,000? Are you going to use it in 1 month or 12 months? So all these things, these are very important. Marketing. Your marketing doesn't just include SEO. You need to go for exhibition, etc. You need to go overseas to market your product. Singapore is a very small place. You need to market overseas. You need to travel out of Singapore. Are you going to take budget airline? Are you going to get, or are you going to use, you know, you support SIA? So you need to know all these things. How much money you need to be used? And do you need to employ overseas managers to help you, those local from Myanmar, from Thailand to help you? Because you cannot just go in. You're not allowed to do that. You need somebody from the local. You need to pay them money. How much does it involve? So you need a fixed marketing plan and a figure for initial startup. Because if you don't even have that, you can't expand your company. So give yourself a ballpark figure, and with that, you can proceed on to your infrastructure, like how your contracts will be, how you're going to prepare a proposal. Okay? I have ever received a proposal, okay, just a 5-page. I wanted to set up my website. I wanted to revamp my website. I read somebody gave me a 5-page website that doesn't tell me how long will I be able to get my website done, what is stage 1, what is stage 2, what is stage 3. The language I'm going to use, the warranty, nothing at all. It's a startup company. I have another company, they give me a 20-page, okay, a close to 20-page, telling me the details and what will I get. And after the first, after the 6 months, not first, after the 6 months, if I want to use their service to add on, what do I need to pay? And the cloud hosting service fee for 12 months. All these are indicated properly. You need to identify all these things. Because even though if you do website, it doesn't mean the customer won't need you to help them to source for cloud hosting services. So all these things, you need to get it ready. So when I look at the five majors, I don't know anything. I do not know what are the additional costs that I'll be incurring after 6 months or after 1 year, the maintenance costs, the technical support. So I can't make a decision, so I won't go for this company because I will be worried if I need to change anything and it's going to cost 10,000 and I didn't know, and because of the license fee, I need to pay for my API integration, and there's nothing measured on it, it will be very worried. My website will be down. So it's important that you get your basic information in your sales contract draft up before you even find your customer. I think you can go and Google, it's all around the place. And then you have to have a product listing and a warranty scheme. Okay, whether it's 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, okay, any payment in terms of like if I go to your office, all the transport costs, will I be charging you? Okay. And then we have the invoice and funny notes method. How you're going to prepare it and how it's going to be in the system. Okay? A lot of people think that this is nothing. But frankly speaking, when your volume goes up, when you have a portal, okay, and you actually give your consumer a chance for a refund within 30 days, you need to identify all these things. How your administrative staff is going to understand how does your system work, your process flow. You got to write this all in the plan, do a drawing. Okay? So who's going to approve it? So if somebody wanted to get a refund when it's more than 30 days, who is going to sign for it? Is the CEO going to sign for it, or is the sales manager going to sign for it? You must get all these things right. Okay, so it's not easy. And then the payment scheme, like PayPal, there's a lot of ways, e-nets, all these things. So all these things you need to connect to all the relevant vendors and understand how you get your money back. Because for PayPal, I do understand that the money can be transferred back, right? As and when you want, you can actually, you know, fix a timing like 1 month. Because every time I think you transfer some money, it will be incur a cost. So all these things you need to plan properly. You can't be, if you never plan properly, when you are really starting the business, what happens? You are the only decision maker. Nobody is going to help you. And you need to look at all the information and you need to delegate out the work. So it's better that you actually understand all these things. Okay? Get a PA, get admin staff to help you on all these things. So when times come, you can focus on your business, looking for sales, enhancing your product and services. Okay. Next, okay. When you have done all these things, you will be preparing your accounting, your unaudited report and tax report if you are a private limited company, and then your AR, AGM methods. Okay, for startup company, they will prefer to outsource their accounting services because it's cheaper and we have the expertise. But for bigger firm, when you are like 5 years old, some companies prefer to have their own administrative staff. So it will depend on the scale of your company. There's no right or wrong. It's just a matter of how you want to do it. Okay, and for our company, we actually focus a lot on cloud services. We have cloud accounting services, which we actually are using Xero and QuickBooks to help companies. Okay, this one is actually more for e-commerce trading company. Okay, because what happened is that we are using QuickBooks, so customer can actually issue their invoice, issue their receipt from mobile apps. Okay, so for tech startup, it might not be in this way. So different industry has different standard. Okay. Some companies, when they're at their second or third phase, 5 years old, QuickBooks, Xeros are not longer applicable to them. Okay? Because they might have inventory, they have vast inventory. They need markup system, they need a project management system. So they might need an ERP system, okay, that can integrate with their CRM. So different companies do different do differently. Okay? So to sum up, before you start a company, understand the capital structure, how much you need, 6 months, think. So just for yourself, $5,000 times 6, 30K. Okay? Next, you will look at your IP. For IP, the cost might range from 2,000, 3,000 onward. This is what I mostly I've heard about it. Okay? Look at the office space. Minimum, you have to have a 6 months, okay, rental, and thereafter you can expand your company. You can maybe give yourself about $1,000. That will be more than enough, or even cheaper, it's just a hot desk. Okay, and you have to look at your sales strategy. So it will be another $100,000 to $200,000 marketing fee. Okay, last but not least is a cloud accounting solution, which you will need somebody do your accounts, your unaudited report. Okay, the cheapest it can go from is $1,400 for accounting services, unaudited report, and tax report for the first year. Okay, and if you need a nominee director because you are not local directors, or you want to branch out to a company without letting your existing boss know, you need a director first, you need to pay about a nominee director fee of $1,500. A lot of people do that. I'm not joking. I'm a nominee director for a few companies because they do not want their boss to know first. Okay? So I can't say who is that. So this is what they do. So after 2 years, they give themselves 2 years. 1 year, they start their company quietly. End of the year, they will quit their company. Okay? And by the end of second year, we will cease to be their nominee director. So they'll come in as a director. That's what happened. And usually, the husband or the wife will be the shareholders, or even the cousin or whoever. They want to do it this way. But they do not want their cousin or their whoever to be a director because they still want to maintain a separation. Business is business, work to work. Because when we do this for them, what we do is that we have a documentation that mentions that we are not liable for anything. We won't cite any documents that that is on management decision. We won't be dealing in any management decision. Okay? So that's very important. And you will need to do all your calculation and planning. Do not start a company just because you have a fantastic product. You have to learn about the money, you have to understand your manpower, you understand your office, your sales strategy. It's very important. Out of 10 companies, out of 10 IT startup companies, is it 9 out of 10? Okay, out of 10 IT startup companies, 9 fail. They have a fantastic product, but they do not have the money to continue because they forget about one thing. You can't survive without money. Yes, your product is very good, but what happens is that by the second year, you no longer can survive by yourself. You need investment funding. Okay? And that is the point when you realize that your business structure is wrong, your documentation are not done properly, okay? Your marketing plan are not prepared properly. So you will need a team. Okay? Okay, so that is the end. And what happens is that even though most of us are not started, I believe because all of you have your own companies, always remember, okay, you must have that spirit, okay, in your heart, no matter what, because that is only the time that you can help yourself and help people. Today, I'm able to share my story with all fellow business owners. It's because I went through the path when I'm all alone, I couldn't find the money, I have to work from home. And I understand the issue that's been faced by my entrepreneur and that entrepreneur. They wanted to take care of the families, yet they need the money. They feel that I already studied so far, I have a degree. I have worked in the company for so long, but I have to satisfy. But I wanted to do more. So that is where I'm coming up to help all this company. So if you need more information, okay, you can always go to our Facebook. What we do is that every day, we will share information about startup issue, entrepreneur issue, the grants and the tax issue that you are going to face in the near future. Okay? Over there, you will learn about what the Singapore governments want us to do. Digital marketing, like recently, I think one of the ministers mentioned about that in a video clip, and we also share it inside our Facebook, so that all the entrepreneurs and even business owners will understand where are the avenues they can find a firm. I think recent talk is somebody is giving us $200,000, right? IT company. Yeah, for IT company, right?
fintech startups.
Yes, fintechs are 200,000, the latest news. Yeah.
For trials.
Sorry?
For trials,
yeah.
So it's all a lot of qualification.
Correct, a lot of qualification. But 200,000 is a lot. Because for A Singapore, I think we are only getting 50,000. And there's a lot of red tape. You need to be a... Oh no, you don't need to be. You cannot be a business owner. So I'm not eligible. So I don't have that 50,000. So I need to look at that 200,000. Okay, so if anybody wants to help me, let me know. Okay, so this 200,000 is very important. 200,000 can help you on your capital, your intellectual property, IPBs, or case and strategy, it can help you for the 200,000. For the first 1 year, definitely it can help you. Okay, and when you have start your business right, following, you can get more fund from venture capitalists, crowdsourcing, there's a lot of ways. But you must remember, can the study right, understand the help that the Singapore government is giving us. They are giving us a lot of help, especially Singapore. Yeah. If you can, go to SME Center, they will help you on all these things. I have a mentor over there. They taught me about how I can help my company, which is why we embark on cloud accounting solution. All my people are called cloud accountants. We work not just as a bookkeeper, we help customer. And I myself actually travel around and I actually communicate with my staff even though they are at home or in that office or in this office. So going forward, there's a lot of help coming out from the government because the market is really bad. Because I am in this field, a lot of strike-off happening for the last 10 months. It's not a joke. I've seen too many companies shutting down, okay? So understand where is the money coming from. Grab the money from the government, start your company right. Even you have started your company wrong, it's still not too late, okay? Focus on the important things that I mentioned, get your paper done properly, and you will definitely succeed. Always have a positive mind, okay? I'm always quarrel with my partner, because he's always spending money, okay? That's why I'm the CFO, he's the marketing guy. Marketing guy and accountant will always quarrel, and it's normal. It's very normal. They will need more budget. I say more beer session, more this, more that. I say yeah, correct. Okay, so always understand what are the necessary costs and plan properly. Okay, so that's the end of
my. Any questions?
Yeah.
Elijah?
Right.
How do you shut down a company?